Hi, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. Do you know CapCut has a website version and desktop version now? This will be a complete guide for the CapCut desktop version. I will walk you through the basics on navigating the app on the desktop. If you think this video is helpful, please give this video a thumbs up. It would really help boost the YouTube algorithm for this video so more people can see it. As we go through this app, please comment down below what's your favorite feature of the CapCut desktop version. Now let's get started. First, you want to go to CapCut.com. If you want to use the website version, you can just sign up and log into it. I will not go over the website version since this video is for the desktop version. So you can click on download for Mac or Windows, depends on what you have. After you download it, install it, then you would see this icon. Click on it to open your project. On the main page, you can log in at the top left corner. You will see all your project's details here. You can see them in grid or see them as list. You can use whichever one you prefer. You can click on the three dot to rename, duplicate, or delete a project. Before we get started, let's go to global settings. You can make a preference on how you want to create your videos before you get started. For the first one, we have project, which you can choose to don't delete cache files or have them auto-delete after certain days. The next one is edit. We have free layer, which means if you have the free layer on, you can arrange the order of overlay by moving them on different track. If you have the free layer off, then you would change the order of the overlay by changing the number like the mobile one. For performance, if you feel like it's lagging when you are editing your video in the app, you can choose to have proxy mode on, which means it would lower the quality of your video when you are editing them, but when you export them, it will use the original file. You can make a preference here. This means all the project you start will use that same setting. Click on start creating to start new project. You can click on import to import your videos, audios, or pictures. You will see your video as list or as grid, whichever way you prefer. To start your project, you can click on it. You can trim off the video before you even move it to the main track by adjust on the edge to trim out the part that you don't want. Then you can either click on the plus icon or just drag the clip to the main track. If you want to add clip to the overlay track, you can just drag the clip above the main track. For audio, it's just the same thing. Under media, you can see a logo where you can import your files. There's also library where it has some stock files that you can use. Now let me show you how to edit your footage. So click on the clip. You will see on the right side that different tabs pop up. The first one is video. Under video, we have basic where you can adjust the size and position. You can adjust here, or you can just tie in the number here if you want. If you want to add keyframe, you can click on this icon if you want to adjust the size, position, and rotation. So let's make it smaller. And then you can go to the next spot. So that's how you can add keyframe to your clip. If you want to remove the keyframe, you can simply unclick. So that's how you can remove the keyframe. The next one is blend, which is just like the splice function that you see on the mobile one. You can adjust opacity, stabilize for video, facial beauty and body, where you can make adjustment on a person. The next one is cutout. To use chroma key, just select it, then select the color you want to remove, adjust the strength. So that's how you can use the chroma key. The next one is auto cutout, which is to remove background on a person. So let's click on this one. Click on auto cutout, then it will remove the background. So the next one is mask. You can use whatever mask you want. With mask, that means it would only show the mask part. If you click on the video on the main track, you will also see the options of canvas, which means you can change the background. So click on canvas, you can select blur, color, or style to select the background that you want. You can apply to all the videos on the main track if you want. Then the next one is audio, which you would see this option on videos only, not pictures. You can adjust the volume, noise reduction, add voice effect to it, The next one is speed. You can adjust the speed with normal or curve speed. Next one is animation. You can add in animation, out animation, or combo animation. The last one is adjust. You have basic. You can import LUT file to it if you want. Skin tone protection, adjustment, that different adjustment you can make here. Whenever you see a diamond icon, that means you can add a keyframe to make adjustment to it. The next one is HSL, which stands for hue, saturation, and lightness. Let's go to a color view so you can see the change. For HSL, you can change a color when you select on it. So let's change the color of yellow. Let's say you want the yellow to change it to the color more next to it. In this case, let's try to do green. Let's move it to the right side. You can see the color change more to the green. If you move it to the left, you can see it change more to the orange. Adjusting the hue to left or right, it will change the color toward the color on its left or on its right. You can also play around with saturation and lightness with it. So that's how you can edit footage in CapCut. The next one is audio. There are different music that you can use. If you are making video for YouTube, just be aware of copyright songs. The next one is sound effects. There are different sound effects that you can use. You can extract your audio from a video. The next one is text. We have default text, effects, text templates,
auto captions,
which it would generate captions if you have a video that's already talking with English, local caption, where you can import captions file. So let's click on text to add text. You can click on the plus icon or drag it to the track. You can click on here or here to adjust it. You can move it to wherever you like. If you want to change the font, you can click on here. You can see that different fonts. You might wonder, how can I use custom font? You don't need to import custom font on the app. Any font you import to your computer should show up in here as well. You just need to scroll it to the bottom till you see them. You can see that I have a lot of different fonts that I import to my computer and they already show up in here. Then you can play around with size, style, color. This is pretty much just like the mobile one. The next one is bubble. You can add a bubble to your text if you want. You can go to effects if you want to use effects text. The next one is animation. You can add in animation, out animation, or loop animation to your text. You can adjust the speed. Then the next one is text to speech. You can select whatever sound you like. Click on it, then click on start reading. Then it will generate the audio from the text. You can also make adjustment to the audio by click on it. You can see you can change the volume, fade in, fade out, noise reduction, add voice effects to it, or change the speed to it if you want. You can also add keyframes to it as well. So that's how you can use text to speech in CapCut desktop version.
Hi, it's LC.
The next one is stickers. To use the stickers, it's just like text. You can either click on the plus icon or drag the stickers to the track. You can make adjustment to it. You can add keyframes to it or animation to it if you want. So that's how you can add stickers. The next one is effects. To add effects, you can either drag the effect directly on a specific clip that you want, or you can just go to the track and click on the plus icon or drag on the top, which means the effects will apply to all the clips under that timeline. Let me adjust this so you can see the effects. To make adjustments to the effect, you can click on it and you will see options on the right side. Let's say you don't like the effect on your clip. You can right click on it, click on effects, and then click on the delete icon here. And then it will remove the effects. So that's how you can add or delete effects. The next one is transitions. For transitions, you can either click on the plus icon or drag it in between two clips. And you can adjust the duration of it. So that's how you can add transitions. If you want to delete a transition, you can just click on it, click on delete. The next one is filters. To add the filters, is pretty much just like effects. You can either drag it to the clip, or you can click on the plus icon, which it would apply to all the clips under that timeline. If you want to remove the filters on a specific clip, you can click on the clip that you have the filters, then go to video under basic, you would see the filters icon, uncheck the box, then it would remove the filters. So that's how you can add or remove filters on your clip. The next one is adjustment, which is the same as the adjustment we saw earlier, except this one would apply to all the clips under the same timeline. You can just make adjustment to it or SL adjustment to it.
Here's where you can import your own LUT file.
So that's how you can use these functions on the top. Now let's go to the function right here. You can click on this icon to have the select option or split option if you want to split your clip. Then you can just cut your clip like that. If you want to undo that, you can click on this icon. Let's go back to select. When you click on the clip, you will see different options. So we have undo, redo, split, delete, freeze, reverse, mirror, rotate, and crop. So you can play around on how you like it. If you click on an audio, you would see the match cut. This is where you can add beat to it. And this one is to clear the beat. So these are the basic functions that you can use on your clip. Over here, you can see quality. You can select performance priority or quality priority to priority your playback speed or priority your resolution. This is RGB parade. Here is the format that you can select different format of the screen. This is to make the video on full screen. You can also adjust the panel by moving it like this to make it bigger or smaller. Right over here, we have record. You can add voice over. The next one is main track magnet. What that means, if you have this off, when you move the clip on the main track, they will not snap to each other. If you have it on, you can see the clip move to right next to each other like a magnet. The next one is auto snapping. What that means is when you have it on and move your clip, when you see the blue line, you know the edge part of this clip is aligned with the text. If you have it off, then you would not know whether it's aligned perfectly or not. The next one is linkage. What this means is when you have it on, every time you move a video on the main track, if you have text and stickers under that main video, they will also move with the video. When you have it off, that means when you move the video, the text and sticker would not move with it. So that's what linkage means, is to link your main video to the title and stickers. The next one is preview axis. What this means, you would see the yellow line, that's the preview axis. So you would see it as you move your cursor to whichever part. If you have it off, then you will not see it. The next one is to zoom in or zoom out your timeline. Over here, you can mute clip audio. That means you would mute all the audio on the main track. Now let's click on the video, right click. You can see the option to copy the clip, cut the clip, delete, edit, which this function you see over here. We have group, which means you can group your video on the main track, overlay track together if you want. Let's try to group all of this together. So you would select them. For MacBook, you can hold on Command and select all the clip you want. Then right click and then click on Group. So whenever you move them, they would move together. So that's how you can use Group. You can also click on Hide Clip if you want to hide certain clip or hide an entire group of clip. So that's how you can group multiple clips, text, and stickers together. You can also ungroup all the clips, stickers, and text that you grouped together. You can separate audio from the clip or replace the clip. Edit effects if you have added the effects to this clip. Range, you can select an area by clip, which it would turn this part in to bright color or unselect area. You can also click on any place of the timeline and then right click, you will see range again. This one you can see in point, and then you can go to another place and set out point. Just like select an area by click, this part turned into bright color. What that means, when you export your video, anything in the bright color will be exported. But anything in the gray area, you will not see them when you export your project. So pretty much the range allows you to set your in points and out points or select an area where you would like to export that part of the clip. You can also unselect an area so you would export the entire clip. So that's how you can use the range. If you don't want to use the mouse to edit your video, you can also utilize the shortcuts, which you can see here. Instead of clicking on the split icon, you can use the shortcut function. Depends if you have Windows or Mac. For Mac, we click on Command B to split that clip. The shortcut would be really helpful if you want to utilize this on a daily basis. After you finish your video, you can click on Export and you can play around on the setting on how you like it and click on Export. So that's the basics on navigating CapCut desktop version. If you want to learn specific things on using the desktop version, please comment down below. If you think this video is helpful, don't forget to hit the like button. It would really help grow my channel. As always, please be nice to yourself and have a wonderful day. I will see you next time.